Welcome back to the Middle-earth Shadow of War Gravewalker difficulty walkthrough, where we will capture the forts of Ghashgor here in Gorgoroth, the last one that we need, before moving on to the Brightlord quest, which is the last of the Altarial quest line. If we have enough time, we'll move on and do some of the subsequent quests as well, but let's see how far we get. As you can see, I haven't done a whole lot in Gorgoroth, so before we go on and assault the fortress, what I'm going to do is deploy a bunch of orcs on my side, infiltrate the enemy war chiefs, and take down the defenses, and then move on to the assault. I could probably manage to just assault the fortress, but I'm doing it the easy way just so you guys can. If you struggle, if you end up dying trying to take the keep head on, you can do it this way and it'll make it a bit easier. So the first thing I'll do is buy a bunch of silver war chests. I should have enough Mirian at this point after I've purchased my siege upgrades. So actually, let me show you that first. So you can see I've purchased all of the siege upgrades that I need already. So I've grabbed Sappers, Defender Host, Cursed Siege Beasts, the Wargrog, Mounted Archers, and Overpower. And I usually use these ones in online assault so that I can capture the enemy keep more quickly. So these are the ones that I always buy. Once you have these, you should have a decent assault force, particularly after you take down the enemy defenses. So before you go in and buy war chests to deploy orcs, make sure that you have the siege upgrades that you want for your assault force. I have enough Mirian to purchase 10 chests, which will give me 20 orc followers, so it should be more than enough for what I need to do. Now, I really don't care about any of these orcs, so I'm just going to deploy them randomly until I have the entire map turned blue. Yeah. Well, that's not so good. It killed one of my guys that was infiltrating. I'll try deploying one more. Sometimes you hit this point where you'll be unable to deploy orcs without killing your own. If you hit that, stop this, and then focus on the captains that you need to dominate yet. Taking out the ones that I've already infiltrated, so I just need to work on the ones that are remaining on my own. So we'll try and dominate this guy first, that way he can infiltrate his captain. We'll get Prak the Thirsty after that. And then Bork the Tricky, and then the other captains don't have anybody assigned to them. So we'll make sure that we infiltrate two of our followers to each of the war chiefs, and then we'll go ahead and do the betrayal missions. And we'll get Aslar first.
I bring the Dark Flame's message to you and your kind. It is written in the blood of outsiders. Come, and I shall speak it to you.
Yeah.
cease your suffering!
Of it. I don't. But I do know that I'm gonna kill you. And then. All right. I'm gonna have some more grog. And then I'm gonna kill you!
You're gonna have the food.
So basically all I did to open up there was I saw that he was, he will be dazed by execute, so charged and dazed him. Also looks like he's enraged by pinning, so we will not do that again. Four chases. It's easiest if you just, if he's not immune to arrows, then pin him and then let your captains take him out.
Typical!
Next step in the process will be to infiltrate all of the war chiefs.
Muzu.
little on the dull side, but you'll do.
You'll be in the dirt in no time.
Look, a Ghashgor. Yeah, that's
Track, your face is annoying. I really want to slice it off. Come on, you coward. Can't lose the living. Nice. Ugh, you look like a show-off. I hate show-offs.
We're running out of victims already?
Another damn Ghashgor! Kill it! Get down!
If that does happen and you don't feel like messing with the captain, you can just deploy another one.
Yo! I've been searching high and low for the traitor you've got hiding in our ranks. The search is tedious and annoying, but I will find him.
It's one or one. You will serve.
Whatever you want, Bright Lord, my lord. I was just getting started!
Just a trifle. Nothing for you to worry about.
Another idiot. I'm always facing idiots here.
I am the master of pain!
You better not underestimate me. I want a good fight.
I got so much more pain to give.
I'll show you. Let's see you go.
Typical.
This won't hurt me. You're mine! Yummy!
Grisha.
You've been lucky so far, and that luck is about to end!
Give me someone proud. I do like it when they're proud.
A catacomb!
When I'm done with you, you're going to look like overcooked Ghashgor!
You can have the food!
They lack the grace and precision of the elves, yet they persist in flinging arrows our way. Nazu.
You won't be getting past me!
You look weaker than the last glob! A Caragor! See for me! I will put you in your place!
Another victim! Come on!
Have betrayal missions for all of the war chiefs. So we'll go through them one at a time, kill each of the war chiefs, make sure not to dominate, which we learned in a previous episode, but to just kill them off. So we'll kill them one at a time to lower the defenses.
Incredible view from there! You can see your death approaching!
For the Bright Lord!
Next up, Harhenok Betrayal.
You! I see you up there, Gravewalker! Maybe you want to stay! When you come down, I kill!
Let's get started with them! Get things going!
Stinking traitor!
Betrayal mission.
This way!
Looks like we've found our entertainment for the day. You're dead, Ranger! I serve the Bright Lord!
Next up, betrayal mission for Shaka, Fleshburner.
Come here, old lover! Me and the boys want to show you some orcish kindness! Always hated you!
Shaka.
moment. Still, I can make time to kill you.
For you all over. Now I spread you all over.
Die, master!
Asgrels.
Tasty morsel, too small to be full meal barred. Interesting little tidbit. You are delicacy.
Before we actually do the mission to capture Ghashgor, now that we've killed all of the captains, we're going to go in and set a new bodyguard so that we don't lose Bruce. And we'll want to try and find somebody who won't be dazed or killed instantly by whatever we get hit with. Muzu the Angry looks pretty good. He's only vulnerable to stealth and beast fodder, both of which we can control in the throne room, so we'll assign him as our bodyguard.
Muzu.
We'll also make sure that we equip all of our siege upgrades. As usual, we'll have sappers, defender host, whatever siege beast you want, war grog, mounted archers, and overpower. This is not a timed mission, so you can do inspiring banners instead of overpower. I just tend to use overpower though, so that I don't have to spend the extra Mirian. You know, later on you can unlock them all if you want to, but this should work just fine. Now that we have all of the defenses lowered, and we've assigned all of our captains, it's time to take the fortress in Gorgoroth.
Of the Uruks, forged in battle, backs to the wall. You cannot break us. You can only break yourself against us. This fort dominates all the land around, and soon it will echo with the screams of your armies, and you will beg for mercy, mercy that will not come.
Remind me not to put the old overlord's head on a pike. Too hideous, even for me.
After we take this last fort for the Bright Lord, after we cut down those defenders, oh, imagine the feast!
Look! They're in the desert!
before you head in, make sure that you top up your health shot. If you haven't already, you can kill some of the prisoners to do that if you need to, and switch to Drow.
Is both duty and pleasure.
Krosh.
So we don't have any more guy flies in here, so we'll have to rely on dazing him by killing his pets and members of his gang. And also beast fodder. Keep in mind that he is poison-proof and is immune to curse. And Frost enrages him, so we're going to want to avoid pinning shot and vaulting over him.
It's too bad both will go unfulfilled.
Getting attacks from archers up top, so what I'm going to do is dominate the archers really fast. So I'll probably just rely on Shadow Dominate for that.
Yeah. sit on that throne, Turk, and you will know only despair. I've lived it.
As usual, I'll look for a marauder. Next thing we'll want to do is set up our keep defenses really quickly. It's not really all that important which captains you promote. I do like to keep Bruise in the keep though, so that during online conquests and such, he'll be there to kind of entertain people with his gibberish. So kind of fun to have him around and run into him. We are now ready to do the Bright Lord quest, but I've just remembered that we get a reward at the end of the quest. I'm not going to spoil what it is, but I'm going to see if I can hit level 60 first before I do this, just to see if it affects the levels of the reward or not. So I'm going to go away, hit level 60, doing the Nemesis missions, and then come back. One thing to note is that I'll want to stay away from the Vendetta missions. So in order to level up, what I'm going to do is grind out a bunch of Nemesis missions, which will not be fun. If you don't care about gear levels, then you don't need to do this. I'm just going to do it to see if it will affect the gear levels or not. And once we know that, then you'll know if you should hit level 60 first, or just keep going, or if you don't really care, then continue on and do the Bright Lord quest.
We have conquered the forts of Mordor.
Then it is time to take the fight to Barad-dûr and to Sauron.
Isildur awaits.
We bring this water.
We have conquered the forts of Mordor! But it is still not ours! Sauron's army advances, ready to butcher every last one of us! But we will not die under his rule! We do not serve the Dark Lord! We will sally forth on the battlefield and take this land for our own! You fight for Mordor! You fight for the Bright Lord!
Yeah.
weak. Finish this once and for all. Give me your worst, and don't hold back!
Rogue.
For my height. Dance. We've been at it for far too long. You may have come a long way, but it ends here.
Skark.
Time has come, Jalliath. All that you have bought is rich here. We are bound together in this brotherhood. This is the fate of kings and men.
It shall not be mine.
We will devour Little Bird.
I cannot allow this. Isildur, I release you!
No!
Find peace in death.
He was not yours to release.
And he was not yours to enslave.
I did more than that. You broke Sauron's hold. You dominated him.
And I will dominate Sauron. His armies will be mine.
We are meant to destroy Sauron.
Sauron cannot be destroyed.
Celebrimbor is right. We fight and fight, but evil always returns. Talion, we can end this here.
We must ensure Mordor is restored to light, not darkness. Trade one Dark Lord for another.
This is not the end I have fought for!
But you are not the only one fighting.
No, he is not. This is not about your petty vengeance. Or mine. This is about restoring order to Mordor. To all of Middle-earth. Fought for. You are but a vessel, and there are others. The Lady Galadriel sent you here for a reason. Together, we can bring Sauron to his knees. We can finish what our people started so long ago.
Sacrifices are not in vain. This is the only way.
See the future you have wrought. A bright lord instead of a dark one.
You pitiful man. I gave you sight, and yet you still do not see.
You showed me a fate I could not change.
You are wrong. When you and Celebrimbor forged a new ring of power, I saw where your path ended. Locked in battle against Sauron at the top of Barad-dûr. And you won. Sauron was enslaved, and the Bright Lord rose in his place. The armies of Mordor marched forth under his banner, and Middle-earth fell under his heel. That is the future I fought against. The future you prevented, because you saw Celebrimbor for what he was.
No.
Your war is not yet ended, Talion. Whether a bright lord or a dark lord rules Barad-dûr, the balance of power must be maintained, or all of Middle-earth will fall.
Minas Morgul.
Yes. From there, Mordor can be held back.
Gone.
I asked you once, how much are you willing to sacrifice? Open your eyes. Open your eyes, Talion.
As long as I have breath in my body, my fate is my own.
Must have rocks in your head. This is Minas Morgul, and you are one man.
I am one. But we are many.
Did you hear that? I'll kill you! I'll kill you as many times as I die!
Watch!
fight. I smell something.
Stop and fight me! I've got him here! Get behind me! Something to...
Ah! One of the Hollow Men. now.
Serve the bright Lord now.
In the body of elf or man, you are unchanged, Celebrimbor.
You
is the wrath of Galadriel!
I serve no one.
Sauron and Celebrimbor became one, locked in a prison of perpetual war. A flaming eye casting its shadow over Mordor. Talion had retaken the city of Minas Morgul, but his war was far from over. His greatest battle would be fought against the shadow within himself and the tower to the east. To hold back the darkness. To save the world of men.
Well, that's too bad. Now we know that the ring race set that you get for completing the quest gets awarded at the bottom level, even if you're level 60. So that's unfortunate, but at least I can update the description to indicate that. And I think we'll end this video here. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed, and we'll see you in the next episode.